Hey, it's John, Enduring Charm. You know, I've resisted upgrading my old leveling laser here. This is a really old Fat Max by Stanley, and it only shoots a single dot. So I get three dots out of it. And you know, it's served its purpose over the years. But I've kind of resisted upgrading to something nicer because of the cost. So in looking at what's available now today, you get lasers which shoot a continuous line, horizontal or vertical or both. I was looking at some of the big name brands and they're quite expensive. I was put off by the price because, after all, I can do this manually. It's not the end of the world. But there are also other options, brands that are not big names, which are much less expensive, like a fraction. And as I was looking at that, coincidentally, I was contacted by this company, Kaiweets, and they offered to send me a unit for evaluation. So, hey, I took them up on it. The model is a KT360A, and it comes, actually, it's very well packaged. It's got a foam insert here, so this is going to survive kicking around a truck. So you get the laser unit itself. You get two batteries. These are lithium ion batteries. You get a charger, which is a USB style charger. There's the cable. And you get a receiver here, like a target, if you need that. And you get this base here, which has connections for the two common style of tripod that are available. So what I'm curious about is quality, number one, build quality, how well it works as far as ergonomics and that kind of thing. I'm interested in accuracy. You know, how far can I shoot this laser and still get something useful out of it? Battery life is another issue we want to talk about. So I'm going to do some testing here, both in the shop, and then I'm going to bring this on a job site and actually try it in real life and see what we get out of it. As the unit is charging, these lights will indicate that it's doing something. It starts with a red light and goes to this green. When it's done charging, those lights will just stop blinking like that, and you know the charge is complete. Installing a battery is simple. There's the contacts right here. It's pretty obvious how it goes. So you just slip that in on one side and try to just one-handed, and it clicks in place. Now this unit projects a green line, not a red line, which is said to be easier to see. And you have three possible planes, if you will. It will project a line this way. So you can see that on my hand, I hope, like that. It will project this way, and it will project this way. So you get three different possible projections there, and you can select which one you want at one time. So if you're not using one, you can turn it off so it's just not blinding you and getting in your way. You can use this button right here to cycle through the possibilities. So that will turn on one laser or another just by cycling through it. Now, like many of these lasers, if you are out of level beyond what the unit itself can make up, because it's self-leveling, it will blink at you. So if I turn this, it starts blinking like that. That means you have this mounted on a level that's beyond what the unit can make up. Once you return to a level that's within 4 degrees or so, then it will self-level and it'll be fine. There's also a pulse mode indicated here. What that means is the laser will shoot out a high frequency pulse, which is picked up by a receiver, which is not included here, but you could purchase. And that's for very long distances. How useful that is for me, I think probably not very useful at all. For me, I'm doing residential work. I don't generally use a laser for very long distances, but it is there if you need it. And of course, the last switch here is a lock. So there's a self-leveling device in there, but when you're moving this around or storing it, you don't want that device just bouncing around. So there's a lock here. You just slide this. That's on, and the laser comes on. If you slide it to the off position, it locks that self-leveling mechanism in place so you don't damage it. Now the manual, because you may need the manual, is actually pretty good. I was actually surprised. Very often, you know, these are an afterthought, but in this case, they look like they did a pretty good job covering anything you could want to know. Has the specifications here. There is a 3-year warranty. So, you know what? I can't complain about the manual at all. They've actually done a pretty decent job. So with those basics covered, now I want to get into the bigger question. How accurate is this thing? Is it going to hold up on the job site? Are the batteries going to last? You know, these are the more important questions. What I'm going to do for one thing is to test this against my old laser, which by today's standard is probably not that accurate, but it's served me well enough. So if I put this against this, am I going to find differences in the line level? That's something I want to find out. If they're pretty close, then that's going to give me one answer. And as I'm doing this, we'll check the batteries as far as how long they last and that kind of thing. So I'm going to get into some testing here in the shop first, and then I am going to bring this on a job site and actually use it and see how I like it. Okay, I'm going to do some quick tests for accuracy. Now, this older unit here I have set up side by side with the Kaiweets. And I'm not saying this older unit is perfectly accurate, it may not be, but it's been good enough for what I do. And I have them set up side by side here and found out that the level of this plane is about the same or almost identical to this one. So that works out well as far as testing. So I have this, both of these lasers projected against two opposite walls. This one here is very close, and you can see the red dot lines up almost perfectly with the green level. And the opposite end of the shop is about 32 feet. And if I walk over there, I find at 32 feet, the red dot is slightly lower than the green, but so close that it's within, I don't know, a 16th of an inch for sure. Okay, in this test, I'm going to look at the vertical plane. So this older laser here, basically it's an electronic plumb bob is what it amounts to. So that's a dot that goes up and down, and you can see the dot on the bottom here. And I have the green line from the Kaiweets lined up with that red dot here. And I have another laser over here. Same thing, I have the red dot. I don't know if you can see it in there. Actually, I got to make a slight adjustment, it looks like. There. I have the red dot lined up with the green line here. So down here on the ground, those are in line. Now if I look on the ceiling, this is a 10-foot ceiling, and I can see the red dot lines up perfectly with the green there and perfectly with the green there. So I mean, 10 feet is enough for me for the work that I do, and those are in perfect alignment. Okay, this side plane is the only one I haven't tested yet. This is kind of weird to test, but what I did was I set up this old one with a dot facing this way and a dot this way. Over on this wall, you can see the red and the green line are aligned. And you can also see that the green line goes right across the red laser coming out there. So I know those are aligned. And again, I'm going to go to the opposite wall. And we find that the dot is it's actually slightly off from the green line, but so close as to be almost meaningless. And now this is about 24 feet. Now, one more way we could test for accuracy, I have a square here, and what I've done is I've set it up so that the green laser just barely kisses the edge of it, and I want to make sure that's the same all the way across, and it is. And then on this edge, same thing, it just barely kisses the edge of it. I don't want to get my camera and the laser here, but if I look there, that is perfectly lined up. So, okay, one more way to test for square on a bigger scale now is to use the 3-4-5 method, which means if I measure 3 feet this way and 4 feet this way, if I connect the bottom quarter of that triangle as we're looking at it, that would be 5 feet. Or I can make it bigger. So in this case, I measured 6 feet this way, and I measured 8 feet along the line this way. And when I get down close here, you can see it measures between the two 10 feet. So that's dead on. Now up to this point, we've been talking about self-leveling operation. In other words, you turn this on and the laser will find its level. And if I move it a little, it'll bounce around and find its level again. But there are times when you want manual level, meaning that it won't self-level, it'll just display a line, and then you can move this unit however you want to adjust that line on a wall or something. Why would you want to use this? Well, very often I'll work in a very old house, and I have to decide whether I want to make something perfectly level or whether I want to follow the ceiling or follow the floor. And in that case, you would want a manual mode. So there is a way to do that. If I turn this back off, Now that's locked, so it won't self-level anymore. And if I hold the mode button down for more than 3 seconds, it comes on. And that line will just move however I move the unit. It won't self-level anymore. So that could be helpful if I want to follow the ceiling or the floor or whatever. I could make a, or maybe I'm just doing a diagonal for some reason, I could do that. All right, I'm pretty satisfied with accuracy. I don't have any issues with that. Let's talk about build quality. You know, when I look at my old one here, again, this was not a super expensive laser, but build quality is not great, honestly. It's, you know, these rubber pieces come off. You know, it is an older unit, but the switch has been difficult. It's just been finicky sometimes. And to get the batteries in and out can be a pain. Now, this older one uses AA batteries, which is one advantage in that, you know, the batteries run dead. You could run out to a store and get some AA batteries. But it's been so-so as far as build quality. Build quality on this, I'm actually somewhat impressed. It feels solid. It's got enough heft to it where you feel it, but it's not so heavy that you can't throw it on a cheap tripod. And that's what I did here. I use a very cheap tripod. It's probably a $10 tripod. And it's not so heavy that the tripod can't handle it, but the quality is good. I mean, it feels solid. It does have rubbery surface here on the battery and on the other edges. These towers, which kind of protect the laser inside, are all, you know, heavy-duty plastic. It's plastic, but it's heavy-duty. I don't have any issues with the build quality. If you look underneath here, it has those fittings for any type of tripod. So there's the smaller one and the bigger one there are the two standard types. The battery, to get it out, you press down here and the battery slides out. So with the battery out, you see the contacts there. It would be easy to clean. Even those contacts, if you needed to adjust them, if they got dirty or something, it wouldn't be that difficult. The battery pack, again, well made. It does have this display here for how much power is left. There is a dust cover here for the USB. You know, there is one drawback in the sense that if both of these batteries go bad or they run out of power, you don't have any more choice except to power them up with the USB cable and wait for them to charge. Whereas, you know, the older unit, you could just use AA batteries off the shelf. However, you know, I've been playing around with this for a good half hour, 45 minutes. The battery is not even beginning to be discharged. They give two batteries. There's a spot in the pouch here for it to keep the other battery. So I would say I'm not that worried about it. The controls are super easy to use as well. You know, you have the lock or unlock here, and then depending which laser you want to use, or if you want to use all of them, you just cycle through it. So you just keep pressing this button and it turns one on or all of them on or whatever. You could have any combination you want. I also want to briefly mention this, which is a magnetic base. So it has the magnet here. It also has, you know, the two fittings for tripods. And then the unit itself is attached to this using this little thumb wheel here. So this is pretty standard. The little target card they give you, it has centimeters and inches, and it has a magnet right here for attaching, and it has like a little stand right here you can use as well. Now out in bright sunlight, it shouldn't be a surprise, you really can't see the laser very well. Now in this, I mean, I have shadow from the sun, so it's bright sun, and I'm only a few feet away, and you can just barely make it out by eye, probably not even on camera. There's a vertical line right there. If I hold the target up, it's a little easier to see, but you know, it's not really effective in bright sunlight, and that's really not a surprise. I don't think any laser does very well in bright sunlight. So look, I'm going to bring this on a job site. I'm going to try it. Now that I've tested accuracy, I'm pretty confident in it. So I'm going to try it in a few different situations, see how I like it there. You know, but so far, honestly, I'm pretty impressed with it. For the price point, I think it's about $200. This is pretty hard to beat so far. All right, on the job site here, it becomes immediately apparent how nice it is to have a full line, a continuous line, rather than just a dot. So here I'm aligning the center of this window. So that's where the laser is, right here on the center of this window. and I bring the line down so that I can align the bathtub drain. It's going to be a freestanding bathtub, and I need to be able to align that drain in the right place. And this makes it just so much easier. So I've got that on a very cheap tripod, and I'll mark with pencil where the laser line is so that I don't need to keep the laser on permanently. In this clip, I'm checking where the top of the wainscoting, it's a beadboard wainscoting, will go. I need to make sure it's above the outlets. And now I'm checking the floor height versus this level line and realizing that the self-leveling is not going to work. So I'm switching to manual mode, and I'll press this button, and that puts me in manual mode. Now I just need to tweak the line using the tripod. There's my old line where that pencil mark is, and I can put this line wherever I want now. It's not going to be level, but what I'm doing is following the floor and the ceiling rather than actual level, because I need it to look right, not actually be level. Here I do some more and just double check where the top will be, and I'm pretty happy with it now. Once I'm happy with it, I'll put some pencil marks so that I can find where I need to be later. Now in this clip, I'm aligning the laser with the drain where the vanity is going to be, and I want to check where the electrical is for the vanity lights. So I'm checking both sides. This is a double vanity. Now here I've put the tape measure on the center line of the toilet flange, and I'm checking where the vanity edge will be in relation to that toilet. In this clip, I'm checking the shower pan or the shower floor curbs, which I have not yet built. I want to make sure those alignments work well as I go with the tile up the wall and towards the ceiling. Now I'll check the other side as well, make sure I'm happy with that. And I can make sure with that laser line that the tile bullnose, which I'll be installing, is just right, and it is. Here I'm checking the center line of the drain of the shower in relation to the niche that I'll be building later as well. And finally, I'm checking the bottom row of the tile that I'll be installing and making sure I'm happy with where that ends up on the floor and on the ceiling. So I've had a chance now to use the Kaiweets KT360A in a real life setting. You know, when somebody sends you a tool to review, or if you buy something online, especially from a brand you may not be familiar with, you don't know really what you're going to get. But in this case, I have to say I'm actually pretty impressed. As far as accuracy, no problems there, at least in a residential setting. Now, if you're using this outdoors, like any laser, it may be difficult in bright sunlight, but in shade or beginning or end of the day, you might be all right. Lately, though, I've been doing a lot of indoor work, and so this really fits the bill. As far as build quality, it feels substantial. The switch and the detents when you press the buttons all work really well. Everything's very well laid out as far as the ergonomics, so no problems as far as build quality. Really, the only complaint I can think of is that the battery is a pretty tight fit, so it takes two hands to remove it and replace it, but really that's a very minor complaint. Incidentally, everything you see in this video was done on one battery charge. I never used the second battery, and there's still plenty of charge left in the first battery. So as far as battery life, no problems there either. I have to say, another thing I'm very pleased about is the packaging. So having this nice foam case here, everything is really well laid out, and I appreciate the effort going into that, because keeping this on the job site, it gets bounced around in the truck and the trailer on the job site. And having everything accessible here easily is a big deal to me. So for a couple hundred bucks, you're going to get the laser, you're going to get the extra battery, the charger, the little target here, and this little adapter here, which has a magnetic mount. And it's a pretty good package. I have no problem recommending this. I don't see any major issues at all. And what I've experienced in the past week or two using this unit has been nothing but good. So I would say for the price, you really can't beat it.